I've always wanted to be like Claire Foy when I grew up.
And we've liberated ourselves. We will have to ask ourselves who we are.
Huge congrats on Women Talking. The ladies in this have to make a life-changing decision. And as actors, I feel like you guys are constantly taking risks. What's a role you've taken the biggest risk on in your careers?
All of them are,
it's terrifying. You jogging every time. I'm like, yeah, every time scary. But that's why you also do it.
Yeah, I think that there's got to be an element of like, this could go really badly. Or that just seems to be the element of everything that I've ever done. I think if it's too safe, then it's not quite the reason to do it.
You smash it every time, both of you.
Not every time. I can name a few where it hasn't gone that well.
I'm just so happy that you're both finally in a project together.
I know!
Finally!
Finally!
All these years!
This is what we've been waiting for.
Me too!
What are your favourite projects of each other's, though? Because you're both two of my faves.
Oh my God.
So everything.
No, so many. I've got to say that in War and Peace, she was my absolute... No, but look, bear with me.
The Nun.
A revelation. I honestly watched it only for her. And just every time she was on, I was like, just get rid of these people. Who are these? These famous people. Get rid of them. I just want her. I just thought she was... Like, that was the first time I think I'd...
I've always wanted to be like Claire Foy when I grew up.
And here we are now.
Here we are. I did. Like, you know, she just has always been incredible and inspiring and has always, like, whatever woman she plays, whether it's the Queen or whoever, is like, it's just real women, and she gives them so much humanity, and I feel like I just think she's incredible.
I think she's incredible.
I'm getting emotional.
It's also kind of embarrassing, isn't it?
It's very embarrassing, yeah.
And look at you now, matching here today.
Oh, God. The Shining.
We are. We're one step away.
It's very full circle. I love it. We've got to talk about the star of the project, Rooney Mara's fart machine. Who had the most fun with it?
Obviously. Rooney had the most fun with it.
Because it happened so out of the blue. We were like, is it a crew member? Is it like, who is that? Nobody, and obviously nobody says anything initially. Or did we laugh? I can't remember.
No, no one said anything initially. But also I think because there was some confusion because it could have been a phone. Because it wasn't just one fart. It was lots of different farts.
And there's different variations of the fart.
They were all different personalities.
Like a symphony.
I never not found it funny, I've got to say, and I don't know what that says about me, but every time it happened.
It's amazing. And she'd planted in different places around the room, so it could have been anybody.
Yeah.
And she's so, you know, innocent, kind. She's not innocent. She's not innocent.
No, she's not innocent. No. No, but she's. You wouldn't think that woman's got a fart machine on her when you look at her.
But apparently you took it, Jessie.
Did I?
Yeah. This is what Sarah was just telling me.
Thief. No, I have
apparently
bought
got
one.
Really into it.
I've bought one myself since and brought one on set, but I actually haven't put any batteries in it because I'm not very good at organising.
Yeah, she didn't steal Rooney's fart machine. I'm just going to support her, and I will stand up in a court of law and say that that did not happen.
Maybe one day, if you're lucky, Rooney will gift it to you.
Yeah.
You'll need one. It should be in an actor's, like, toolkit.
In the contract moving forward.
What else would be it? No, let's not discuss that.
We have been preyed upon like animals. Maybe we should respond like animals.
Your characters are doing everything they can to ensure a better future for the next generation. Who in the industry always really guided you and supported you when you were starting out?
Oh, that's an interesting question.
Oh my God, I have had so many incredible people in my life who've done that in different ways. I mean, I guess in the industry, like, people like Dee Dee Gardner, who's produced this film, who produced Moonlight, who produced 12 Years a Slave, who's always done the films that should be told but never have somebody to be brave enough to tell them. She is Fran McDormand, like, you know, she's just a punk. Yeah. And Claire, Sarah, like, lots of people. My friends, my girlfriends, my mom, my sisters, like, I just feel like so lucky to have met really incredible people throughout my life who've encouraged me to be braver in myself. And I don't think I would be able to do that without so many of them.
I love that. How about for you, Claire?
Yeah, I think that I wouldn't necessarily say that there was like a wealth of people in the industry at the period of time that I entered it who were like picking women up and like showing them how to do it. I think it was much more you learnt by accident or you learnt by example of what not to do. And all of those lessons were wrong, basically, because I've now realised I've worked with people who I like people like Dee Dee and Fran and Sarah, who are in positions of authority and who show how to do it in a way that is respectful and understanding and compassionate and all those things. But there is a director called Dervla Walsh, who I worked with very early on.
She's and Irish?
Yeah.
Oh, I know her, yeah.
Yeah, and I watched her work 15 times harder than every other male director that I worked with, and I watched how she would run, she would bleed bleed it dry. She would never, if there were 5 seconds left to do another shot, she would run back and forth and she would get the camera, and I just saw how hard she worked, and she's incredibly successful
what
now.
What did she do with her?
Little Dorrit, it was called.
Oh, yeah, and she's Fargo with her.
Did you?
Yeah.
She's wicked. She's wicked. And she was a real example of, I was like, that looks exhausting, but look at you go. Like, look at you do it. Yeah. Look at you push that, you know, massive ball up the hill. She was very kind. She was very kind to me and also tried to be very like, don't do that. Don't do that. Don't accept that. Yeah, you know. But she also had her own career to think about. But yeah, I think the existence, I hope, like with Kate and Liv, who are in this movie, who are the younger actresses, just the fact that we exist now, like we've done that, this film exists, I think is a massive sign of what can be done, especially in our industry.
It's so important. And Jessie, I just love your description of Frances McDormand, a punk.
Yeah, she is a punk.
Love
She's
that.
She's a total punk.
Yeah.
How emotionally challenging was it to immerse yourselves into these roles? Because I imagine it must have been tough.
Yes and no, because you got to go to work with the best, you know, the most incredible actors in the world. It was like so exciting. You know, you never knew what was going to happen. Anything that you thought was going to appear in the script was like 100 times more and richer and wild, and you just never knew which way you were going to be tugged. So like, I mean, it was a privilege. Like, it was an absolute privilege to go to work and stand, you know, beside and in front of all of these incredible women and men and Ben and the crew. And I think I didn't realise actually what the impact of an experience like this would be in that time, because in some ways it was too much. Like, it was so much to hold, and we had to hold it all for each other all the time. But I guess that's the incredible thing about Dee Dee and Sarah and Fran, is that they had support in place for us to be able to fall apart when we needed to, and know that there was going to be an on-set therapist there if we needed that, that we as the company that they put together were going to hold each other for all of that, and that Sarah would hold us during that time too. And that meant that you were constantly taking constantly taking risks and constantly opening your heart further and further and further. So, because it felt safe, and actually there was something, I don't know. Like we all wanted to be there. Like, we all wanted to go to the hayloft to discuss this thing that we'd always thought but never spoken out loud. That's a very long answer.
No, but that's right.
How about for you, Claire?
Yeah, I think the same thing. I think that there was a huge amount of responsibility, and also, like, I felt so honoured to be trusted with it, that there was a really respectful distance from the material and me. But I think that basically it would be naive to say that it didn't really impact me. And also, I think I underestimated how the other character's story would impact me. I think all of us did to a certain extent, because I think there was no way of preparing yourself for the honesty and the, like, the vulnerability that all the other performers in the room were going to give you. And there were definitely moments when I was I had to take a break myself, because I couldn't quite engage. I was like, I can't believe what I've just seen, almost. Or
yeah.
I hadn't really heard that when I read it. When you hear someone say the things that these women say in the script, it's very different to reading it on a piece of paper.
Yeah.
Like, it's very, very different. And so, yeah, I don't want to say it was like, it was fine. Like, there were really serious moments. But I think it's like Jessie said, like, also there was just a huge amount of, like, I was just felt so, I just could not believe that this story, I was being entrusted to help and work with these other people. There was also an element of just like, just, my God, drink it in, like, just enjoy it.
I still feel like that.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like this film is a touchstone for something that is going to change something. Mm. And it'll be slow. I don't think it's a sensationalist story. And I don't think this conversation is born out of it being sensational. I think it's something which is ancient that actually is keeps moving. But to be part of this moment and, like Claire is saying, have the responsibility, but also the kind of inspiration that this story is giving us and seeing it, you know, now it's yours. Now it's the audience's to do with it what you will. And so incredible to be part of something like this in a lifetime, like incredible.
Well, you've both done the most amazing job. Thank you so much for talking to me. Huge congrats. I've always wanted to speak to you guys as well. So it's so lovely to actually get to meet you.
Double whammy.